हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज विशन सर। दिस इज माय 23rd वीडियो टुडे एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स इन्फ्लुएंसिंग इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। इन अवर प्रीवियस टॉपिक डिफरेंट मेथड्स टू मेजर द प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड। After the completion of different methods to measure the price elasticity of demand, the next topic is what are the different factors affecting elasticity of demand. Okay, student, don't get confused. Yes, the question is explain different factors influencing elasticity of demand. Yes, because the similar type of question you can observe, explain different factors affecting demand or influencing demand. So this is a different question. And what are the factors affecting elasticity of demand, ED? This is the different question. Okay, so before going to start these 9 factors, let us quickly revise different types of price elasticity of demand, because the answer of these factors are hidden in different types. You should know different types of price elasticity of demand. Okay, what is meaning of price elasticity of demand? Price elasticity of demand is the ratio of percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in price and other factors remain constant. It means the demand changes only because of change in price and other factors remain constant. Okay, and there are 5 types of price elasticity of demand. Yes, number 1, perfectly elastic demand. It means a very small or very slight change in price brings infinite change in demand, and the slope of demand is horizontal and it is parallel to x-axis. Okay, it means only demand changes, price of the commodity remain constant. Second type, perfectly inelastic. And perfectly inelastic is opposite of the first type, that is perfectly elastic demand. What is the meaning of perfectly inelastic demand? Yes, a change in price does not bring any change in demand. It means only price changes, price increase or decrease, but there is no change in demand. Demand is constant, demand is unchanged. Okay. And the slope of demand is vertical. Yes, it is parallel to y-axis. Yes, after that, the third type is unitary elastic demand. And in this case, what happen? It means price and demand changes in a same percentage. Yes, equal percentage. Both are changes in a equal percentage. Yes, 10% rise in price brings 10% exactly fall in demand. Yes, and the slope of demand is rectangular hyperbola, straight downward sloping line. It is a unitary elastic demand. Yes, and number 4 is relatively elastic demand. Yes, so these factors you should know, and you should also know the what is the meaning of relatively elastic demand. Yes, the relatively elastic demand means a small change in price brings large change in demand. It means price changes less and demand changes more. It is called as relatively elastic demand. The slope of demand is flatter. You can see on the screen the slope of demand is flatter. this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis. The slope of demand will be like that, flat. Means a small change in price brings large change in demand. Yes, price changes only that much, 10%. And it brings how much changes in demand? 20%. So these entire determinants depend upon these two types, that is relatively elastic demand and relatively inelastic demand. So you should know, yes, how much price changes a very small percentage and demand changes in a large percentage. You can see this area, okay, and the slope of demand is flatter. Because while learning these topics, while learning these points, you should know, if I say the slope of demand is flatter, you can easily understand it is a which type. It is relatively elastic demand. And what is the meaning of that? Yes, small change in price brings large change in demand. Price decreases, demand increases. It means the law of demand is valid here. Okay. And next type is the opposite of fourth type. Yes, fifth type is opposite of fourth type, that is relatively inelastic demand. Yes, relatively inelastic demand. What is the meaning of that? A large change in price brings small change in demand. It means price changes more and demand changes less. So it is called as relatively inelastic demand. Yes, and how the demand curve looks like? The demand curve looks like steeper. This is the flatter, and in the case of relatively inelastic, it is steeper. Yes, it looks like that. Y-axis, x-axis, point of origin, and the slope of demand is steeper. This is a steeper demand curve. Yes, it means this is the original price, this is the original demand. It means price changes more and demand changes in a less percentage. So it is called as relatively inelastic demand. It means a large change in price means price increase by, for example, 10 rupees to direct 20 rupees, and demand decrease from 10 units to 9 units. So what is this? It is relatively inelastic demand. Yes, you should know that much before going to learn the different factors influencing elasticity of demand. So you should know different types, different slopes of demand. Yes, different name of the commodities, name of the goods. Which goods have more elastic demand, which goods have less elastic demand, which goods have perfectly elastic demand, which type of goods have vertical demands, okay, in this way. So I hope you got different types of price elasticity of demand. Yes, the slope of demand sometimes horizontal, sometimes vertical, sometimes rectangular hyperbola, sometimes this one flatter, and sometimes steeper. Yes, so here the demand changes only because of change in price. It is called as elasticity of demand. Okay, so what are the factors influencing elasticity of demand? So on your screen there are different factors influencing elasticity of demand. Yes, there are not one or two or three factors. There are many factors influencing demand, and in the place of influencing, you can say what are the different factors affecting demand. What are the different factors affecting demand? Instead of influence, you can say what are the factors affecting elasticity of demand, or you can say what are the factors determining elasticity of demand. Yes, so instead of influencing, you can say determining, you can say factors affecting. ओके, लेट अस मूव क्विकली. ओके, नेचर, फर्स्ट वन इज नेचर ऑफ द कमोडिटी. नेचर ऑफ द कमोडिटी मीन्स नेचर ऑफ द गुड्स. यस, इन आवर इकोनॉमी, इन आवर हाउस होल्ड, देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ गुड्स वी ऑलवेज परचेज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लग्जरी गुड्स, यस, कम्फर्ट गुड्स, यस, नेसेसरी गुड्स, यस, ड्यूरेबल गुड्स, सेमी ड्यूरेबल गुड्स, लॉन्ग लास्टिंग गुड्स. सो बिकॉज ऑफ डिफरेंट डिफरेंट गुड्स द डिमांड ऑल्सो चेंजेस. बट हाउ मच इट इज चेंजेस? यस, सो the nature of the commodity also influence the elasticity of demand. Why? Because if the commodity is luxury goods, so the demand for luxury goods is what? Relatively elastic, means it, the demand changes more and price changes less. Because what do you mean if I say the demand for luxury goods is relatively elastic? What does it mean? It means a small change in price brings large change in demand. Yes, you just remember the different types of price elasticity of demand. If I say the demand for luxury goods, and luxury goods example we have already seen, which type of goods included in luxury goods, like car, bungalow, yes, diamond necklace, yes. And luxury goods are those goods the people use these type of goods for show off, to create the snob value effect in the economy, to increase their status in the economy, to it is a status symbol. Yes, so luxury goods are, the demand for luxury goods are relatively elastic. It means a small change in price brings large change in demand. It's a luxury goods. Yes, so here what happened, demand changes more, yes, because of small change in price. So it is relatively elastic demand. Yes, what is meaning of elasticity of demand? Elasticity of demand means demand become elastic. Elastic means change, either demand increase or demand decrease. So here demand increases more because of small change in price, because of small decrease in price, or because of small increase in price, there is a large change in demand. Yes, so this type of goods determines the elasticity of demand, that is luxury goods. Yes, and the demand for comfort goods also relatively elastic. What are the example of comfort goods? The goods which makes the comfort to the people, means the goods which is very, which become very easy for the people, which make easy the work of the people. For example, washing machine. Yes, washing machine, it's a comfort goods. Mixer, grinder, these are the comfort goods. Why? Because these goods make easy work to the people. Yes, the people cannot means they don't want to wash their this one cloth by hand. So if they bring this one washing machine, it will make easy, it will give some comfort to the public. So it is a comfort goods. Yes, so demand for comfort goods are same, that is relatively elastic. Yes, a small change in price of the goods brings large change in demand for that goods. Yes, so the slope of demand is what? The slope of demand is flatter. The slope of demand is flatter in the case of luxury goods and comfort goods. Yes, let us see the second type of good. The second type of good is necessary goods. Yes, necessary goods includes the medicine, food, grains, textbook. So demand for necessary goods are relatively inelastic. And what is the meaning of relatively inelastic? The relatively inelastic demand means a large change in price brings small change in demand. Yes, in this case the price changes more and demand changes less. So the slope of demand is steeper. So in this explanation in first point, you have to learn two main goods. One is a luxury goods and second is necessary goods. So demand for luxury goods are relatively elastic, yes, that is flatter slope, and the demand for necessary goods like food, grains, medicine, it is relatively inelastic. Okay, so you can go this way. Okay, second, the availability of substitutes. What are the example of substitute goods I have given in the previous lectures? Tea and coffee, these are substitute goods. Lemon juice and sugarcane juice, these are substitute goods. So the demand for substitute goods are, which is very close substitute, yes, the demand for substitute goods are relatively elastic. Okay, and the goods which have no substitute, the demand for those type of goods are relatively inelastic or inelastic. For example, the goods which are close to, means they are substitute with each other, that is tea and coffee. So when the price of tea increase, people demand more of coffee. So demand for coffee will increase. So if the demand for coffee will increase, it means the coffee have more elastic demand. Demand is more elastic of coffee, means demand changes suddenly. Why? Because its substitutes are available in the market. Yes, what is the substitute of tea? The substitute of tea is coffee. What is the substitute of lemon juice? The lemon juice substitute is sugarcane. Yes, what is the substitute of Coca-Cola? The substitute of Coca-Cola is Pepsi. Yes, so if the goods are available in the market, so it has more demand. Yes, but some goods are having no substitute. Some goods are having no close substitute, like salt. We cannot use other things instead of salt. Salt is very important to make the vegetable. Without salt, the vegetable cannot be made by the housewife. So what is this? So the demand for salt is inelastic. Means, if the demand is inelastic, it will slope like that. Vertical slope. Yes, perfectly inelastic. Means, whether the price of salt increase or decrease. Yes, whether the price of salt increase or decrease, the demand for salt is constant. Means, it means whether the price of salt increase from 20 rupees to 100 rupees per kg, for example. So we cannot stop to buy the salt. We have to purchase the salt to make our vegetables. Or whether the price of the salt decrease from 20 rupees per kg to 2 rupees per kg. So we cannot increase our demand for salt. Yes, if the price of the salt increase, we cannot reduce the demand. And if the price of salt decrease, we cannot increase the demand for salt. Why? Because salt is that commodity, the salt is that goods which cannot be increased or decreased by the consumer. We just need a pinch of salt to consume every day. So the demand for salt is inelastic. Yes, so here demand become inelastic because of, why? Because of salt. And the substitute of the salt is not available in the market. So demand is constant. And if the substitutes are available of that goods, the demand is elastic. Yes. So in this way, the demand for goods changes because of their substitute goods. Okay. So you can see this way. Third, number of uses. Yes, some goods are there which have multiple uses, means multi-use, more than one time. Yes, so the goods which have multiple uses, this type of goods have less elastic demand, more elastic demand. And the goods which have single use, it has less elastic demand. Yes? Example, the goods which have multiple uses, like electricity. Yes? So electricity have multiple uses. For example, because of electricity, fan runs, tube light. Yes? Washing machine runs, mobile charging, television runs. So the goods is only one, but it has multiple uses. So demand for electricity is what? It is more elastic. Yes? So number of uses also determines the elasticity of demand. If the commodity which have less use, it has less elastic demand. Less use means single use. And the commodity which have multiple uses, it has more elastic demand. Okay. So if there is a more elastic demand, the slope of demand is which one? The slope of demand is flatter. If it is less elastic, the slope of demand is steeper in this case. Yes, the demand for single use commodity is less elastic, means the slope of demand is steeper. Yes, and the commodity which have more elastic, it is the demand curve is flatter. Why? What is the meaning of flatter demand curve? It is relatively elastic demand. What is the meaning of relatively elastic demand? Yes, small change in price brings large change in demand. Yes, and the commodity which have single use, it has less elastic demand. And if it is less elastic demand, means it is the slope of demand is steeper, means price changes more and demand changes less. And if the demand is more elastic, it means price changes less and demand changes more. Yes, an example is given in your textbook, electricity. If the price of electricity decrease a very short, very small percentage, people start using more home appliances in their house. So demand increases more. Yes, the price of electricity decrease from 10 rupees per unit to 9 rupees per unit. Only 1 rupee change in price of electricity. And it brings how much change in demand? From 100 units to 150 units, means people put more use of electricity. So 1% change in price brings almost 50% change in demand. So what is this? It is relatively elastic demand, means it is more elastic demand. Yes, so in this way you can go through. Next, habits. And some goods are already, we have seen the habitual goods. The habits makes demand for certain goods relatively inelastic. For example, addicted goods like alcohol, like tobaccos, like cigarette, like drugs, all these. So demand for this commodity is relatively inelastic. What is meaning of that? Relatively inelastic. It means a large change in price brings small change in demand. Yes? Why? Because if the consumer become addicted or habituated, so he will purchase the demand. He will purchase the quantity even at high price. Whether the price increase or decrease, the consumer will definitely purchase it. Why? Because it is a habitual goods. Because it is the habits of the consumer. Yes, so demand for habitual goods is relatively inelastic. And if it is relatively inelastic, what will be the slope of demand? The slope of demand is steeper. Yes, the slope of demand is steeper. See, in this case, habits, it's a steeper demand. What is the meaning of that? A large change in price brings about small change in demand. So here it is a steeper slope. Let me draw the diagram again. See, point is habit goods. Yes, so in this case, the slope of demand is relatively inelastic. It means the slope of demand is steeper. See, this is a steeper demand curve. Yes, so original price, original demand, suppose the price of alcohol increases. Yes, so the people will not stop to drink the alcohol. They will definitely drink it because it's the habitual goods. But the demand affected only less percentage. For example, during the lockdown, the government increased the almost 70% extra GST on alcohol, that is wine. So what the people do, out of 100 people at least, yes, 90 people will purchase the goods, or 95% people will purchase the alcohol because they are addicted. Almost the price of the alcohol increased from 500 rupees to almost 900 rupees or 1000 rupees. But still demand is almost same. Demand decreases in a less percentage. Demand decreases, but it's very less percentage. Why? Because the goods is habitual goods. Yes. So, the slope of demand is steeper in the case of habitual goods, that is relatively inelastic. Okay, let us see the fifth one, that is durability. Yes, so in the market, in our house, there are many goods are having different durability. Yes, perishable goods, semi durable goods, long lasting goods, long durable goods. So because of their durability, the demand for that commodity also changes. Yes, for example, if the demand is long-lasting goods like washing machine, yes, refrigerator, furniture, so this type of demand is having which type of elasticity? It is relatively elastic demand. So demand for durable goods are, the demand for durable goods are more elastic or relatively elastic. And if it is relatively elastic, what will be the slope of demand curve? It is flatter slope. Yes, and if the goods is perishable goods, so the demand for perishable goods are inelastic. Yes, because the opposite of perishable goods are durable goods, and the durable goods having more elastic and perishable goods are having less elastic. Less elastic means it is inelastic. And if it is inelastic, the slope of demand you can imagine. Yes, if the demand for goods having inelastic, it means it is vertical slope. And if the demand is relatively elastic, it is flatter slope. So here demand changes. Yes, a small change in price brings large change in demand. Yes, demand for long lasting goods, and the demand for perishable goods are inelastic, means whether the price of vegetable increase or decrease, but there is no change in demand for vegetables. Means we daily need vegetable to eat, we daily need milk to drink. Yes, so demand for these goods are inelastic because they are perishable by nature. Yes, milk, vegetables, eggs, all these are demand is inelastic. Okay, so the demand is also influenced by the durability of the goods. The goods which have long lasting goods, it has relatively elastic demand, and the goods which have perishable goods, which are perishable goods, it has inelastic demand. Okay, example of durable goods, washing machine, refrigerator, furnitures, yes. And the example of perishable goods are milk, vegetables, eggs, yes, fruits, flowers. These are the example of this one, perishable goods. Perishable goods means the goods which is quickly, means within 1 or 2 days it gets spoiled. It is called as perishable goods, yes. and the durable goods are those goods which is for long lasting. For example, refrigerator is for 20 years, furniture is for 20-25 years. Yes, washing machine is for almost, we can say, the 20 years. It is long lasting goods. Okay. Next, complementary goods. Okay, complementary goods. And what are the example of complementary goods I have given? The complementary goods are those goods which is jointly demanded by the consumer. Means consumer have to purchase the goods jointly. Yes, it is called as complementary goods. Remember the different types of demand. In the third type, it is joint demand. The joint demand means complementary demand. The demand the consumer have to demand jointly. For example, car and petrol have joint demand. Yes, mobile and SIM. Yes, so these goods are joint demand. Okay, pen and ink means pen and refill. These are the example of complementary goods. So how the complementary goods will influence the elasticity of demand? Yes, the demand for the commodity which is used in the conjunction with another commodity to satisfy the single want of the society, it is called as complementary goods. And the demand for complementary goods are relatively inelastic. See, the demand for complementary goods are relatively inelastic. Yes, for example, a fall in price of mobile handset will increase the demand for SIM, because mobile and SIM are joint demand. Yes, try to understand the example. If there is a fall in price of mobile phone, if the price of mobile phone is decreased, it means the demand for mobile phone will increase. Yes, if the price of mobile is decreased, means people will demand more mobile phone. And because of more mobile phone, it will increase the demand for SIM card. Because why? Because without SIM card, the mobile will not run. Yes, if the price of mobile decrease from 20,000 to 10,000, what is the reaction of the people? What the law of demand says? The law of demand says that when the price of the commodity decrease, demand increase. When the price of the commodity decrease, its demand will increase. So it happens in the same way. Here, when the price of the mobile phone decrease from 20,000 to 10,000, the people will buy more. Means everybody will buy mobile phone. So if the everybody will buy the mobile phone, what is the result of that? Then the demand for SIM will increase. Because without a SIM card, the mobile will not run. Why? Because mobile and SIM are complementary goods. So here the demand for SIM card increases because of fall in price of mobile handset. So here demand changes. So when the demand changes, it is called as elasticity of demand. Yes, so here demand become elastic because of what? Because of complementary goods. Okay, so complementary goods also determines the elasticity of demand. Okay, next, income of the consumer. The demand for goods is usually inelastic if the consumer's income is high. Yes, it means when the consumer income is very high. Yes, whether the price increase tremendously. Sorry, whether the price increase tremendously, the demand is only small changes. Yes, a large change in price brings only small change in demand. So it is called as inelastic demand. Yes, so the demand for goods is usually inelastic. Means whether the price changes, yes, there is no change in demand. Whether the price increase or decrease, there is no change in demand. Yes, for example, if the consumer has high income, yes, if the consumer has high income, for them it is inelastic demand. The demand pattern of the very rich person or very extremely very poor person or extremely poor person is rarely affected by the significant change in price. Try to understand this example. In this case, suppose a person is very rich. Yes, so in this case, demand is inelastic, or you can say relatively inelastic. It means a large change in price brings small change in demand. Yes, a rich person can afford anything, and for the rich people, price does not matter. Whether the price suddenly increase from 10 rupees to 20 rupees, yes. So for rich people, the demand is very elastic, means changes. Okay, and for the extremely poor people, means very poor. A very poor people, for them, yes, the demand is elastic because they cannot afford. If the price of the commodity increase even 1 rupees, they cannot afford to purchase the commodity. So here the demand changes more for the rich people and demand changes less, almost no change in demand for the poor people. Yes, because rich people is a high income getter and poor people is low income getter. So for the rich people the demand is more elastic, and for the poor people the demand is almost no change in demand. Whether the price increase or decrease, there is no change in demand for poor people. He will usually purchase that much whatever he purchase. Yes, and for the rich people demand is more elastic. Yes, so the income of the consumer also influence the elasticity of demand. Okay, next, urgency of needs. Yes, this is very important topic, you should know. When the goods is very urgent, so for that type of goods like medicine, yes, so demand for medicine, which type of medicine? Life saving medicine, which is very important for life. So the demand for medicine is what? It is inelastic by nature. It means whether the price of medicine increase or decrease, the consumer, the person, have to purchase the medicine, because it is a medicine is a urgent need. It's a urgency of want. We cannot postpone the consumption of necessary goods. We can postpone the consumption of luxury goods like burger, pizza. Yes, so we can postpone to eat, but we cannot postpone the necessary goods, because necessary goods is very important for life. Yes, so demand for necessary goods is inelastic, and the demand for luxury goods which have less urgent, it is relatively elastic. Yes, so demand for necessary goods is inelastic because it has high urgency. Yes, medicine we have to consume on time. We have to take the medicine on time. Yes, to get well soon. So medicine is very urgent need of commodity. So it has this type of demand. It has relatively inelastic demand. And the demand for luxury goods is less urgent. Yes, so it has relatively elastic demand. Okay, so here the urgency of need determines the elasticity of demand. Yes, higher the urgency of commodity, it has relatively inelastic demand, and lower the urgency of need, it has relatively elastic demand. Okay, so if it is inelastic demand, the slope of demand is which way? Steeper. And if it is relatively elastic demand, it has flatter slope. Remember? Okay, next. Time period. Time period means time duration. Yes, short period term, medium term and long period of time. So the elasticity of demand is always related with the time period. Yes, period of time. Yes, it changes with the length of the time. Generally speaking, about longer the duration of the period, greater will be the elasticity of demand and vice versa. Okay. This is because consumer can change the consumption habits in the long period of time as compared to the short period. Yes, if it is short period, we cannot postpone the commodity to purchase or to eat. If it is long period, we can postpone the commodity. Yes, because some commodity have their substitute in the market as far as the long run is concerned. So the time period also influence the demand, elasticity of demand. Yes, and in the next lecture we will see this column. You should know. Okay, in the next lecture. Okay, so in this today's video we have seen different factors affecting elasticity of demand. Yes, nature of the commodity, availability of the substitute, nature of uses, habits, durability, complementary goods, income of the consumer, urgency of needs and time period. Okay, student. So I stop my lecture here. You just keep revising all these things and note down somewhere in your notebook different types along with the explanation. Okay, examples are very important. Okay, student. So I stop my video here. Thank you, class.